Welcome back to Make Me a Fan. I'm the Jag.
I'm Pete.
And we are continuing selections of Great American Bash great matches. Is it the greatest of the great?
Sure.
All right. The greatest.
Ten of the best. How about 10 of the best matches?
All right. 10 of the best matches from Great American Bash. The encyclopedia has carefully selected 10 matches for my entertainment and for your entertainment, mm-hmm. because all these matches are available on the WWE Network. So, Encyclopedia.
Yes, sir.
You mentioned yesterday that today we're going to watch a match featuring the man called Sting.
The man called Sting versus Vader.
Oh!
Great American Bash 1992.
All right, 92. I have a feeling I've seen this one too. Maybe I've seen more WCW than I give myself credit for. All right, Sting versus Vader, Great American Bash 1992. Is there anything you want to say to set this up? Any pinch points? Or we already know Sting. We already know Vader. You kind of know what you're getting when you say
this. This is a classic.
All right, well, hey guys, hit the link in the description or the first link pinned in the comments. Open up that new tab. Watch this on the WWE Network because the encyclopedia is going to press the play button when?
Right about now.
Okay, so I haven't seen this match before. Mm-hmm. First time. And it was pretty damn good.
Yes, it was.
Vader's always in like those David versus Goliath matches,
very
right?
Very much. He's the big man versus the not so big man.
But Sting wasn't exactly small, and he powered out of a lot of things. You know, they really sold Sting's strength in this match. You know, he had him up on his shoulder for a Samoan drop, basically.
Yeah, and that looked great, because he was like 15, 20 seconds selling that Leon.
Yeah, legs are shaking.
And he's like, can I do it? Can I make it? Come on, Stingers. Come on, Stingers. Give me the power.
Yeah.
You know.
It was good.
This is still some of that where the kayfabe wall is up, and it's like you got to get that audience to buy into it.
Yeah.
The realism was there.
Oh, for sure. And I mean, Sting threw a lot of like martial arts style kicks. Absolutely. I don't remember that.
Exactly. Like,
okay, cool. Vader did the laziest Scorpion Deathlock, aka sharpshooter you ever saw in your life. That was pretty bad. That was maybe the low point of the match. But everything else looked great. The punches were really stiff, really sharp, really crisp, mm-hmm. which is a Leon special, right? Testament to Vader. He always kind of lays them in there a bit. And it was a good match. The crowd was into it, and we had a title change.
We did. So, now, unfortunately, Vader only has the title for 3 weeks because you know what happens in Baltimore.
Mr. Ron Simmons comes through
and becomes
the first ever black heavyweight professional wrestling champion.
One of the greatest moments in WCW history.
Most def. And the funny thing, too, because you know Ron Simmons is watching and he's talking to Tony Schiavone, he's scouting him, you know? But I thought Vader, well, that I want to say Mastodon. Whatever.
Yeah, that mask. Yeah,
the mask Mastodon. Thing. That thing, I forgot about that. It's kind of weird.
He used it a lot in Japan, and there was a lot of, it was used in between in WCW in the early 90s, but they didn't bring it out a lot because it had a lot of problems.
Yeah.
And there's, you know, documented stories that it's like, well, it would never break, or it would turn on, and then you'd hit the relay button for it, and it would never smoke. And so, yeah, it was a nightmare situation. But again, it was early 90s. But mm-hmm. you got to applaud Leon for being so forward-thinking in investing in technology and showmanship, especially in Japan, over like Rover with
that. Well, consider the fact, and this is something I was thinking about during the match. I didn't really say this to you, but if Ric Flair is in the WWF,
mm-hmm.
where Hulk Hogan is, and Macho Man,
mm-hmm.
and you know, Ultimate Warrior, mm-hmm. and like these guys are fighting for their lives, you know? Yeah. They have to have showmanship because the stars are in Stanford, you know mm-hmm. what I mean? Like,
for sure.
Man, this is a tough time for WCW.
They
lost the belts. Now we got the new redesigned WCW championship.
Which doesn't look great.
It does not look great.
Looks great around Ron Simmons' place.
It does.
That's about the only high point you have with
it. So again, when you consider what the WWE was doing, this was fantastic, but I feel like they're a little bit outmatched. I love Jesse on commentary.
Oh, for sure.
Jim Ross killing it on commentary. You got Tony Schiavone over there with Ron Simmons. There's a lot of good to be seen in WCW at this time. So excellent choice, good match. And I've got to pick another number for tomorrow, don't I?
You do. You've already looked at number 9 and number 10, but we still have 1 through 8.
Let's go with number 3.
Number 3. Woohoo! We just... Ooh, daddy.
He ain't going to tell you what it is.
Oh, no.
He ain't going to tell me what it is.
No, you
got to come back tomorrow, apparently. That's the game. This is how the encyclopedia does me. So now you guys feel my pain. All right. So bring your butts back tomorrow, 9 o'clock Pacific, 12 noon Eastern. Hit that subscribe button, ring the bell, follow us at Make Me a Fan 316, and we will see you tomorrow.